Good evening, children.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, children. Good evening.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, children. I'm just trying to share my screen. So have you all watched the videos which I shared with you? Ready for the test, children? Am I audible, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Are we ready for the test? Did you all have time to watch the videos?
Yes, ma'am.
And Sindhya and Sanjay, since you're new, are you comfortable with finding the square root by the long division method? Did
yes,
you watch the videos again?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
All right. So children, these are the questions and answers which you would have watched in the videos. Yes or no? Am I right? The questions which you see in this slide?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Just have a look at the questions. I'll give you some time. You would have watched these in the videos. The explanation to these questions in the videos. Was this also a part of the videos? No, right? Find the smallest square number.
No, ma'am.
No, no, yeah, yeah.
No, ma'am.
All right, yes. So children, what questions or what clarifications you need? In the four questions which you see on the screen, any doubt with the answer? You should have marked in case you had some doubts while watching the videos, you should have marked them so that you're ready to ask them now. Okay, this slide. So here, when you find AC in question number 7, in question number 7, when you find AC, 450 is not a perfect square. 450 is not a perfect square. So when you find the prime factors of 450, 450 can be expressed as 2 into 3 squared into 5 squared. 450 can be expressed as 2 into 3 squared into 5 squared. So from 2 threes, 1 3 comes out of the square root. From 2 fives, 1 5 out of the square root. This 2 stands alone. You don't have another 2. We don't have a pair of 2s. There's only 1 2 that remains under the square root. That remains
can
under
I
the square root.
This one?
Yes.
So the 2 stays alone, ma'am. And then we get 3 into 5 into. While the 2 stays alone, we just write as it is, ma'am.
Okay.
So 3 into 5 into square root 2, ma'am. And
no,
then,
I thought you had a doubt, Danya. I thought you have a doubt.
No, ma'am. I'm Devadashmi.
Okay, okay. Please wait. I thought you wanted to ask me a doubt, Devadarshini. Yeah, yeah. If I want one of you to explain, I will name you and then you can take over. All right?
Okay.
Yeah, since the meeting has been recorded, yeah, please take my instructions clearly. Let's not do anything away from that.
Ma'am, can yes. you show the previous slide one? Ma'am?
Can I just finish this one? Yes. So here, two stands alone. So we write that under the square root because it does two does this two doesn't come out of the square root because there's only 1, 2. So from 2, 3s, 1, 3 out. From 2, 5s, 1, 5 out. And this 2, because it does not have a pair, it remains under the square root. 3 into 5, 15. 15 root 2 is the length of the diagonal of the square. Do we all know the formula to find the length of the diagonal of a square? Any idea about the formula to find the diagonal, the length of the diagonal of a square? Okay, so you can make a note of it. The length of the diagonal of a square is given by the expression root 2a, root 2a, where a represents the side of the square. One of you repeat the formula. What's the formula to find the length of the diagonal of a square? What is the formula to find the length of the diagonal of a square? Okay, I don't know if you heard me clearly. So I said the formula to find the length of the diagonal of a square is root 2a, where a stands for the side of the square. So if you see here, the side of the square is given to be 15 centimeters. Am I audible, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, the side of the square is 15 centimeters. So root 2 into side, root 2 into 15, that is 15 root 2. So you can directly, you can find AC using the formula. So then why did we find AC using Pythagoras theorem? Because we are in this chapter squares and square roots. Just to understand what happens when a number does not exist in pairs, how do we handle that situation? Just to understand that situation, we have found AC using Pythagoras theorem. So if you're asked this question, it is not that you have to find, you'll have to find the diagonal using Pythagoras theorem. You can just find using the formula AC is equal to, that is the diagonal, is equal to root 2 into side, which is equal to root 2 into 15 or 15 root 2. I have worked it using Pythagoras theorem just to explain how, you know, you handle a situation where every factor does not occur in pairs. Am I clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Keith, you wanted the earlier slide. Please have a look. Okay, I think we're ready for the test. No questions. Yes. These are the questions. Let's see all the questions first. Let's see all the questions first so that I make sure that you're familiar with all of them. So the first one, find the least 8-digit number that is a perfect square. Is the question familiar to you, children? Find the least 8-digit number that is a perfect square. Have you seen a video based on this?
Yes, ma'am.
Not the same, but a similar one. Okay. The next one. Find the least number to be added to 8,22,700 to make it a perfect square. Watch this, right? Oh, we know how to find the least number to be added or subtracted. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. The next one, question number 3. Solve for x if x square is equal to the number which you see there. Now, if x square is equal to 25 children, what is the value of x? If supposing x square is 25, what is the value of x?
5.
What is it? X square is equal to 25. X is equal to, what is the next step you will write? X is equal to?
5.
No, there is an intermediate step. No, what do we, how do we?
Square root of.
Square root 25, ma'am.
Correct, correct. I think Keetna was the one who said first. Yes, Keetna. Correct, others also. So x square is equal to 25. Next step, x is equal to the square root of 25, which is equal to 5. X is equal to 5. The square root of 25 is 5. That's what you have to do with question number 3. Solve for x if x square is equal to the given number. So you understand what to do next. And you can use the long division method or the prime factorization method. But I told you, when there is no condition, when there's no specification, please use the long division method. There is no mention that you have to use the prime factorization method. So you can use the long division method. The next one, is the given number a perfect square justified? Now, which method will you use? That's what I want to know. Will you use the long division method to work question number 4 or the prime
factorization? Prime factorization
method, ma'am.
All of you share your opinion.
Prime factorization method.
Prime factorization, not the long division method, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, children, fine. Then finally, we have find the square root of 0.354025 by prime factorization method. Find the square root of that number by prime factorization method. So the last one, you're expected to do it by the prime factorization method. Can someone tell me how to start that? What is the first step you would do? By prime factorization method, not long division method. Not long division method. It's by the prime factorization method. So you are not going to take this decimal number to find, you're not going to find the prime factors of this decimal number. You're going to get rid of the decimal point. So what will the number look like? Are you hesitating to unmute an answer, or you don't know the answer? You can just share whatever it is. If you don't know, say you don't know, so that I know that I have to explain.
Ma'am, we should do 354,025 divided by
1 followed by how many zeros?
6, ma'am.
6 zeros. Very good. Very good. That's what I wanted. So the square root of 0.354025 is equal to the square root of, we convert the decimal number to a fraction, as I think that was Danya. So as she said, the numerator will be 354025, denominator 1 followed by 6 zeros. So that way you're converting the decimal number to a fraction. And then you find the square root of the numerator and the denominator. Yeah, and then you know what to do. Yes, children. So any doubts here?
No, ma'am.
Yeah.
No, ma'am.
Yeah, so we'll discuss one by one, children. Finish working the first one. As soon as you finish, we'll see the answer.
So, ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, can you explain the first question one more time, ma'am?
Yes, sure. I will do that. Can we finish the first 4?
Yes, ma'am.
Just before we start the 5th one, I'll definitely do it once again.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yeah. Children, please work the first one. And once you're done, don't give out the answer. Please acknowledge that you have completed. Yes, get started. Write down the question first. All of you do one thing, either take a screenshot of all the questions, or if you cannot, just make a note of all the questions, because I need to unshare my screen. When you finish the first answer and when we look at the answer, I have the second and the third also beside it. I have the second and third answers also beside it. So which makes it difficult to, discuss the first answer. Yeah, so please take a screenshot or please write down the questions. I'm going to unshare my screen.
Ma'am, wait for a few minutes when I'm writing the questions.
You're writing the questions, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Right, right.
I'm
unsharing my screen, children. What's the progress? Finish the first one.
No, ma'am.
Doing, ma'am.
All right, all right. I'm right here. Please acknowledge when you're done.
Ma'am, I finished.
Yeah, who is that?
Madhumita, ma'am.
Yes, Madhumita. Tell us the answer with the first one. Children, you can't see my screen, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, Madhumita. All right, yeah. Yes, Madhumita, what is the, okay,
ma'am,
what is
the number? 1,10,896.
1 lakh?
It is the least 6-digit number. It's the least 8-digit number that's a perfect square.
Just count if it has 8 digits.
Yes, ma'am.
But you said 1 lakh.
Sorry, ma'am. 1,10,896.
Oh my God! But I don't have that answer with me. Let's just try asking your friends, others. Which is the least 8-digit perfect square number? Which is a perfect square? Okay, fine. Now, which number? What is the number which you considered for division? What is the least 8-digit number? 1 followed by how many zeros?
1 crore, ma'am.
1 crore. 1 followed by how many zeros?
7 zeros, ma'am.
All right. Then you start with 3, right? 3 threes are 9.
And then the remainder is 100. And when we multiply with 3 into 2, we get 6, ma'am.
Yeah. Then it is 61 into 1.
Yes, ma'am. 61
into 1. What's the remainder? After that, what's the remainder?
59, ma'am. And then we should bring down the pair of zeros, ma'am.
Yeah. Then what do you have on the sub beside the number 3900? 62.
26, ma'am. 62.
Yeah. So now it will be 620?
6, ma'am.
Into 6?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. After that, what's the remainder?
And we get 3756, ma'am, and the remainder is 144, ma'am. When yeah. we bring down the last pair of zeros, and the beside it is 6322, ma'am.
Correct.
And then we get 12,644, and the remainder is 1756, ma'am.
Correct. Your division is correct, Danya. Now, what is the answer to the question? Which is the least 8-digit number that's a perfect square? What should you do after this? You should find the
square root of that number and the successor number, no, ma'am?
Correct. Not the square root, the square of the successor. What's the square of the successor?
9 crore 9.
What is 3163 square?
One second, ma'am. I will find it now.
Yeah, somebody else complete that. She's right so far. Anybody else share her answer? Has anyone else got the same answer as Danya?
Ma'am?
Yes.
Completed, ma'am.
Yeah, is your answer correct so far?
Ma'am, yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I did the long division, ma'am.
Long division only. What's the remainder you got?
1756, ma'am.
Perfect. What is the successor of 3162?
3163, ma'am.
Okay, what is the square of 3163?
Ma'am, yet to complete it, ma'am.
Oh, fine, fine. Okay, good. Your remainder is right.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Madhumita, what about your remainder? Is it different?
Ma'am, I actually got 1744, but then I noticed a mistake and I'm correcting it, ma'am.
Fine, fine. Okay, okay. Yeah.
Ma'am, I have found that, ma'am.
Yeah.
The square of 3162 square is 9 crore 998. Sorry, ma'am. 9 crore 99 lakh 82. Ma'am, 99,98,244, ma'am.
Okay, that's correct. What is the square of the successor?
And square of the successor is?
Read the digits.
41,000,4569, ma'am.
Correct. Now, which is the least 8-digit number that's a perfect square? What's the answer?
10,00,04569 is the least 8-digit number that is a perfect square, ma'am.
Correct, Dhanya. Your answer is right. Others? The remainder must be 1756.
Ma'am, I got the reminder as 1676, ma'am.
1676
for the long division.
No, we'll not be able to see the answer till we finish the second and third one. No problem, just leave it there. Once we are done with the second and third one, we'll see the answer.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I'm Madhumita.
Yes.
I corrected my answer and now my answer is 1,04,569, ma'am.
Yeah, that's right. What's the remainder you got?
1,756.
And then the number on the top?
3,162, ma'am.
Correct. And the numbers, meaning to the extreme left, that the column of numbers in the extreme left?
3,661, 626, 6,322.
Yeah, you're right.
Correct.
Okay, ma'am. Yes, children, in case you have not got the answer for the first one, don't worry. Take up the second one. Finish 1, 2, 3 and we shall see the answers and we'll understand where we went wrong. If at all we went wrong. Maybe I'll not disturb you. You finish the second and third one so that we can also see the answer. Finish the second and third one. Please do the third one using long division method. Yes, I hope we finished this second one and we have started the third. I'll wait for another 3 minutes and then I'll show the answers. Make it fast. Have you finished the second one, children?
I'm going to finish it, ma'am.
Okay.
Going to finish it, ma'am.
Okay, finish the second one. Let me know. Maybe 3, 4, and 5. I can give it as homework and, you know, I'll open the next test for you. We'll see the next set of questions where we have, more questions based on the videos. Finish the second one. Let me know.
Ma'am, we can use long division method for the third one, no, ma'am?
For the third one, yes, you can use a long division method.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, I finished the second question. One second.
Yeah. Others? Finish the second one?
Yes, ma'am. Completed the second one.
Okay, what's the least number that is to be added?
1815, ma'am.
Do we all have the same answer? Somebody has a different answer?
No, ma'am, same answer.
Same. 1815. No, I don't have that answer. Check. Now, children, you can see the first one also. Please check the first answer and see where you've gone wrong. Get your doubts clarified.
Ma'am, I'm writing the third one.
Yeah, okay. Now, talking about the second one, what's the mistake? You guys are getting 1815, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Please check.
Ma'am, I have made mistake in subtraction, ma'am.
Okay, please correct that.
Ma'am, 907 square is 822,649, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
But there you put 822,700, ma'am.
Let me check. You can see it here. This is what I've typed there. No, my answer is right. I don't see any mistake. See, this is the handwritten. Yes.
7 square is 822,649.
If it is what is the least number to be added, you should not find 907 square. You must find 908 square. You must find the square of the successor.
Ma'am, and we should subtract 907 square and 908 square, no, ma'am?
No. We should find the square of the successor of 907 is 908. Find the square of the successor, which is 8,82,464. See, you can see the steps here. These are the steps. This is what you get from long division. The successor of 907 is 908. Square it. This is the answer. This number minus the given number. 907. Successor 908.
Ma'am, in the worksheet, in the slide you gave, no, ma'am. In that you told like the 907 and 908 square only, ma'am.
No, it lies between them. It lies between this number, this given number lies between 907 square and 908 square. This number lies between 900. Go back to the video and watch it again later, okay? So this number lies between 907 square and 908 square. Now, if you have to find the least number to be added, the quotient we have here is 907. The successor of that is 908. See here, 907 is what we have. The successor of 907 is 908. The square of the successor is this number. This answer minus the given number. This is the least number to be added. This is the least number to be added. And when you add this one, when you add this to the given number, it will become 824464, which is a perfect square.
Now I get the same answer, ma'am.
Yeah, yeah. Please revisit the video, children. And no, you revisit the video. This is what it is. Whatever number you get, take the to. This is the procedure to find the least number to be added. To find the least number to be added. So whatever you have here, find the successor. Take the successor of that number, square it. This is the square of the successor. Now this number minus the given number is the least number to be added.
Ma'am, I thought we were supposed to do it like 908 square minus 907 square.
No. It's not like that. It's not like that. You can revisit the video and clarify. It's not like that. It lies, this number lies between 907 square and 908 square. This number, the given number lies between 907 square and 908 square. So to find the least number to be added, to find the least number the least number to be subtracted is 51 itself. The remainder is the least number to be subtracted. If the question is what is the least number to be subtracted, the remainder is the least number to be subtracted. The remainder is the least number to be subtracted. What is the number to be added? So here we have 907. We have to take its successor, which is 908. Square of the successor, this number. So that new number which you get minus the given number. This is the least number to be added. What is to be subtracted? Remainder is to be subtracted. What is to be added? This is the procedure. Successor, its square, and then the difference.
Ma'am, I finished all the sums, ma'am.
Yeah. Take a screenshot so that you can complete 3, 4, and 5 and verify your answers. We'll take up a different paper because these are similar, no? Just long division, so you can do it yourself. Take a picture of these answers also.
Ma'am, can you show the previous slide 1 minute, ma'am?
Is it over, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Yes, sir. Do question number one now, children. Work out question number one. Yes. What is the area of the rectangle? What is the area of the rectangle? Why no answer, children? What's the area of the rectangle?
416.16, ma'am.
Yeah, correct. Now, what are we supposed to do with that? What is the area of the square?
The area of the square is also 416.16, ma'am, because the area of the rectangle and the area of the square is equal.
Correct. It's given that the area of the square is equal to the area of the rectangle. So area of rectangle is L into B, 40.8 into 10.2, which is 416.16. Correct. Next one, that's the area of the square. Now we need to find the length of the side of the square. How do you do it?
Ma'am, we should take the square root of 416.16.
Very good, Madhumita. Do it. Use a long division method.
Ma'am, I got the answer.
Very good. What's the answer?
Ma'am, it's 20.4 meter square.
Okay, the side of the square is 20.4 meters.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, take up the second one. Let's just wait for your friends to share the answers. Share the answer for the first one. You go ahead with the second one. Have you seen this conversion or no? In the video, have you come across any sum like this?
No, ma'am.
Okay, but it's given there. The area of a square park is 4 hectares. Okay, if that's not done, what about the, I think five, question number five, we can do it, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, question number five, we can do it. After one, do five. Work the fifth one.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. See the answer for the first one, children. You should run this. Area of the rectangle is L into B. So 416.16 meter square. It's given that the area of the square is equal to the area of the rectangle, which means the area of the square is also the same value, 416.16 meter square. So the side of the square will be the square root of area. And the square root by the long division method, you can see it here. And the length of the side of the square is 20.4 meters.
Ma'am, please show the question paper, ma'am, for the fifth question.
Just 1 minute. All of you had a look at the first answer. Yes, we'll work the fifth one. Who was here with the initials DJ? Okay. Mic is disabled, Devadarshini, unless you're talking. And all of you, make sure that you're sitting in a place where there's nobody around you, because the meeting recording should not be disturbed by the, you know, the sound around you. So all these things go without saying. Always ensure your mic is disabled unless you want to talk something. Devadarshini, that's okay. You can text me if you want to share something with me. No problem. You want to share the answer for the first one? Or this, do you want to talk anything about the answers here, Devadarshini?
No, ma'am. I was actually asking the next slide, ma'am.
After the first one, it is the fifth one. Let's see the fifth answer.
Ma'am, I just started doing the fifth one, ma'am.
Yeah, no problem. No. You can just continue working. I was just trying to help, you know, some of them who might need help. So children, first we need to find AB using Pythagoras theorem. You can see the steps here. And then find the value of AB using the long division method. And then go on to find the area and perimeter. You need to find AB, half base into height is half AB into BC. You don't have to copy from the screen, children. You can take help from the screen as you're working. Yes, Cynthia and Sanjay.
Doing ma'am.
No, how comfortable both of you working, because you are new to the class, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Any questions here in the fifth one?
No, ma'am. No questions, ma'am.
Okay.
All I'm right. Comfortable, ma'am.
Fine, nice. Yes, I want each one of you to unmute and let me know. Anish, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Anish. Have you worked all the sums in today's class?
I'm working, ma'am.
Which one are you doing?
Ma'am, the fourth one, ma'am. Ending.
Fourth one? Huh? Oh, meaning, oh, the order in your book. Okay, yes, read the question. Which question? Read the question. Which question, Anish, is that? Read the question. What happened? Raja, are you there? Yes, Raja. Which one are you working, Raja?
Excuse me, ma'am. I'm Madhumita.
Yes.
Ma'am, I'm done with the fifth question, ma'am.
Okay. You had any issues, any difficulty in finding or understanding the answer?
No, ma'am. It's really easy.
It's easy, right? Okay. So the basis is to find square root, to understand the procedure to find the square root using the long division method. How we find the square root of regular numbers, decimal numbers. Once that's the basis, once that is very clear to you, the rest is easy.
Ma'am?
Yes. Yes.
Ma'am, I have a doubt in the area of triangle, ma'am.
Very good. Yes. Madhumita, so that's it for today's session, but you can just wait in case your friends have some questions and you want to listen to that.
Okay,
that's
ma'am.
It. Yeah, that's it for today's session. Yes, Cynthia, Sanjay?
Ma'am, why do we put 1 by 2, ma'am?
Okay, the formula to find the area. Yeah, the area of a rectangle is L into B. But the area of a triangle is half base into height. I think you can disable your mic. Disable your mic. I'm answering your question. Yeah. So, Cynthia and Sanjay, the area of a triangle is given by the formula half base into height. Half base into height. So, here the base and height are the legs of the right triangle. When we say legs, the two sides other than the hypotenuse. AC is the hypotenuse. AC is not the leg. AC is the hypotenuse. The two legs are AB and BC. Which are the legs of a right triangle? The two sides other than the hypotenuse. The two sides other than the hypotenuse. A triangle has three sides. One of it is called the hypotenuse. The other two are the legs. That is the sides containing the right angle. The two sides that contain the right angle, AB and BC, they contain the right angle. See, the sides are AB and BC. AB and BC, they contain the right angle. So AB and BC are called the legs of a right triangle. And the formula to find the area of a triangle is half base BC into height AB. So that is for a right triangle, we also say half product of legs, half AB into BC.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, and perimeter is always sum of the sides, AB plus BC plus AC.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, should I do all the other sums?
No, we shall be doing that in the next class. Do we have any tests in school next week? Anybody here?
Ma'am, I have tests every Tuesday and Friday. Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. I also have tests.
Yeah, so I'll not give you the homework. We'll work in the class next week. Or maybe next week I'll give it as homework.
Yes.
You don't have to. I'll be sharing the next set of videos. Please watch that alone.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. All right, children. So that's it for today's session. If you have any questions, any doubts, you can stay back. Otherwise, you may leave the meeting, children. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, children. Thank you, children.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.